Hello.
Welcome to the show.
MCTV.
Yeah.
Well, we are here in the gymnasium.
As you can probably well imagine.
Here, as people playing basketball right now. Later on, we're going to be playing basketball, my favorite sport. Actually, no, hockey's my favorite sport.
Yeah, I have to say hockey's his favorite sport. It's the national sport of our country and of our school.
Hockey?
Yeah.
I don't really think that's true.
No?
Well, we'll discuss it later on the show.
Exactly.
We got a jam-packed show for you.
It's packed. We got pure adrenaline. We got just stuff.
Just stay tuned.
Yeah.
Ah!
Aside from it being our sports show, it's also, what is it, National Kindness to Others Week or something?
Random Acts of Kindness Week.
So I'm decided to do a Random Act of Kindness. My good buddy Shayne, my co-host. It's a Dodge Viper. It's in the lot.
Thank you, man.
Autographed by Bill Ramford before he left.
I got a 30 cent off a Shake and Bake coupon. I'll give it to you later.
All right, 30 cents off Shake
Dodge
and Bake.
Dodge Viper!
All my baking needs are completed. We're heading over to the activity. We're going to shoot little hoops, okay? Okay, let's go.
And no basketball. We're the Savage Trouts, I guess. We got names made up for us.
We got Calvin here.
Sarah, me, and
Mr. Calvin
here.
Yeah. Nice, sir. And I don't know what the other team's name is. Okay, and our commentators today is Paul Worobec and Kevin Clarkson. Come here, guys. And you guys can start commentating anytime.
Hi, this is Paul Worobec, and yes,
I'm Kevin Clarkson.
The teams today will be Boutestein's Savage Trout and Marchuk's Rampaging Rhinos.
We're going to step out of the way here, and we'll be commentating the game. Hope you enjoy
it. Let the game begin. The teams are Woollven, Marchuk, and Breakhurst versus Sarah, James, and Mr. Boutestein.
Here we go.
Woollven
comes up, and it's stolen. Savage Trout going. Boutestein up
back
at the three-point line.
On the perimeter.
Oh, with the layup. Oh, that's off the mark.
Oh, and that doesn't sink.
Breakers takes it out.
Coming back in.
Oh, there's a Jordan shot. That's out of bounds.
And that's outside. Ooh, that's a pretty sad
play. There's a throw-in on the baseline. James is taking it into Boutestein. Boutestein takes him out.
Oh, with a big move.
He dribbles like a woman.
Coming back in.
Oh, layup. Oh, look at that Jordan move. Oh!
Beauty move by Boutestein.
Well, he's bald and he's skinny and he's tall, so... He makes perfect basketball
play. Marchuk over to Breakhurst.
Oh, Breakhurst misses the easy two.
Nails it off the backboard. Boutestein. Going out of the bounds.
Stolen by Woollven. They call that man the glove.
Boutestein's got the ball.
Dishes it out. Sarah. Sarah dribbling up.
And then picks
she
up the ball.
She stops it. Oh,
let's put it into James.
Boutestein
back
grabs
to Boutestein.
It. Back to Sarah. Shots
oh,
off.
Big shots off.
Now she should be a bricklayer.
Over to Marchuk. Marchuk can't squeeze that. Gets it. Puts it over to Woollven.
Well, we have to go to commercial, so we'll be back in a sec.
See ya.
Hello and welcome to another edition of Sports Day. This week our feature is basketball because the second annual Prairie Wolves Invitational is coming up on the weekend. With me is the captain of the Prairie Wolves senior team. Oh, okay, assistant captain of the Prairie Wolves basketball team. And could you tell me, what do you think your chances are of placing in this tournament?
It's a new competition up ahead, and we have to be one of the stronger teams in 3A in the province, which is Fort Saskatchewan. We've already played them this year, and we lost pretty heavily, so it'll be a challenge.
So where do you think you'll place in the, when the finals roll around?
Hopefully top five.
Top five?
Yeah.
Okay, and last week you played the Harlem Comedy Kings. What was it like playing against those guys?
It was just like street ball. We did nothing organized at all. We just played around and had fun, I guess.
So it was a lot of fun.
Yeah.
All right. Thanks a lot, Chris. Okay, now we have Dwayne Winder. He's on the senior team as well. Dwayne, you played in this tournament last year. What was the caliber like last year?
I think it was the, well, last year was the highest caliber tournament we had ever. Like, I guess we played in the whole season. And that was the toughest competition that we've came up against, except for provincials.
So how do you think it's going to compare to this year's tournament?
Well, this year, again, it's a very high caliber tournament. And we have some of the top teams in Alberta coming, and out of province as well. So it'll be very high caliber.
All right, and what do you think your chances are in placing?
If we can get through our first couple games, we'll have a better chance at making playoffs. So I think it'll determine whether or not how we play against the first two teams.
How do you hope to do in the tournament yourself?
I hope to do very well, especially on the rebound end of it. I haven't been rebounding very well lately this season, so I think the scoring will come if I play good defense.
All right, and last week you also played the Harlem Comedy Kings. How did you enjoy playing against those guys?
It was good. It was like playing, well, the guys from the States, New York and all those places, so it was really hot, really hard. Those guys are dunking on us. I got dunked on like 10 times, like right in the head, everywhere. It was really tough, but it was fun. We had a lot of fun with the guys. The guys are really nice, so it was a good time.
All right, great. Thanks a lot, Dwayne.
No problem.
Hold it, hold it. Hey, fellas, you know another thing?
What's that?
Sure, it's a hairy little booger. Alright, we ready?
Picking on Dwayne.
Oh, yeah.
The tip's won by MCHS.
Dwayne has the ball, it's coming down the court.
The pass, oh.
Takes it.
Oh, good.
It's a big bucket by
that
Dwayne.
That was nice.
His own rebound. Oh, uses the old trick and gets the bucket. The crowd. Double zero with a big pickup. Rest of his life.
His parents will bug him forever.
Double zero taunting my grave. Oh, and we have a jump ball.
Jump ball, jump.
44.
No one passed baseline.
44. Oh.
White cue with the
Would you like some gravy with your stuffing?
White
cue denies him.
Okay, we're here with Aaron Chandler in the gym at a senior girls practice. Aaron, I understand you had a tournament last weekend in Lloyd Minster. How did the tournament go for you?
It went well. We placed third. We first played Red Deer and we won to them, but then we played Saskatoon and lost by 3. So we played for third place and then we beat Saskatchewan and we got third place.
All right. This weekend you have a tournament in Lacombe. How do you plan to place in that one?
Hopefully we should do good. I think the team will do good. We first played Camrose and then Bonneville, and then after that I'm not sure.
All right. Today, the Prairie Wolves play once again in their tournament at 1:15 to 3 o'clock here at MCHS. You're allowed to come to that game if you want. You pay $1 and you can get out of class. On Saturday, is the final game. Is at 7:15 to 9:15. Hopefully, the Prairie Wolves will be in that game. So everyone come up and cheer on your team. This is Ryan Breakers signing off for Sports Day.
Back from Sports Day with this guy, our pal
right
here,
on, right.
Fellow teammate.
Okay.
Okay.
We are the Rampaging Rhinos.
Rampaging.
That's what
rampaging
we are.
Rhinos. Yeah.
We're rhinos, we rampage, hence the
name. Ah, rampage.
We've got a strategy for the next segment.
Do we have a strategy?
We have a strategy.
What will it be?
Okay, come on, huddle up here.
Okay, yeah, okay.
I think
I say we,
our
kick the guy out at his knees.
Yeah, exactly. Good idea. Just knock out his kneecaps.
Yeah.
Okay,
yeah,
all right.
And I'll take the blonde. I'll let the blonde.
15 seconds, we're going to be gone, so let's wrap this up, huh?
I'll take the blonde.
Okay.
And then we'll kick some serious butt.
Right.
Yes.
Okay. We're going to head out butt. To pure adrenaline. That's
heading right. out to pure cool. adrenaline with
That's
Jeremy
That's what
Crawford.
I'm feeling now, adrenaline.
Hello and welcome to first edition of Total Adrenaline, folks, brought in part to you by MCTV Productions. We got a beautiful day here at Rabbit Hill. It's a gorgeous day. How are the conditions?
The great, Jeremy. Good snow, man.
Good snow right here at Rabbit Hill. Come on, have some fun. We're going to have next week, we're going to have some bungee jumping for you guys, so stay tuned. Right now, me and Phil are gonna head down the hill, do some skiing, so we'll see y'all later. Come on out the rabbit hill. Having racers always asking you for keys.
Oh, it's great.
Is it cool?
Yeah, you get to touch your butts.
This is awesome. Thanks for joining us, folks. It's been awesome. And I'll see you next week right here on Total Adrenaline.
Hey, we're back.
Welcome
here.
Back. The score is 1-1. We have Boutestein scoring for the Savage Trout and Marchuk scoring for his Rampaging Rhinos. We'll get back to the game now.
All right, it looks like Sarah has the ball. Coming out to the perimeter.
Dishes it in. Stole by Woollven. Oh, another steal by Sarah. Defensive work by Sarah there.
Oh,
off Boutestein's fingertips.
Out of the reach of Boutestein.
It's a throw-in.
Breakers
is taking the throw-in. He steps in bounds, but I don't think they care.
Over to Woollven.
Woollven. With a little bit of a double dribble, but I think we're playing NBA rules.
Breakers gets it back. Can't shoot Boutestein in his face.
Look at that defense. Woollven out of the three-point line. Oh, tries behind the back pass. Sarah with another defensive
Woollven
work.
Woollven recovers with a big pass over to Boutestein on the
We're seeing
team.
Some prime time show, baby.
Oh, yeah. Boutestein puts it over to Sarah, and that will
off
be
Sarah's
an out of
fingers.
Bounds. Breakhurst will inbound the ball.
Breakhurst inbounds it to Woollven at the three. Pops it up. Oh, off the mark.
And that's a no-go. Breakhurst
with the
ball with
rebound. Misses that.
Boutestein destroys him from behind. Boutestein coming out to the perimeter with the ball.
Oh, a little wraparound dribble. Jordan layup misses it.
It's a layup, puts it off the glass. Woollven recovers with the ball.
Pass it over Breakers. Breakers should take the lane, but he's not. He's still got his dribble. There he goes.
Takes
he's taking the lane.
Oh, Sarah decepts with a big defense. Marchuk is standing in the key all alone. No one's
Marchuk
passing.
Has no clue.
So Marchuk has it. Shoots. Oh, and that's a no-go. Boutestein's got the ball.
Boutestein's got the ball.
Doesn't know what's happening.
Oh, the dish inside.
Pass. Sarah's got the ball.
That even fooled me, Paul.
Oh, yeah.
Boutestein
has it. Over to Kilworth. Oh, Breakers with the ball again.
Breakers over to Woollven. Woollven got to improve on his dribbling skills.
Woollven over to Breakers. So you know they're good for people who don't play basketball that much.
Breakers into Woollven. Woollven with the
The
score is 2-1. Rampaging Rhinos 2-1. Boutestein has the ball up to three. Passes into Sarah. Sarah, overhead pass. Kilworth. A little bit of a travel.
And that's out.
That's out.
Looks like Woollven will be inbound to the ball.
Throws it into Marchuk. Marchuk dribbles out to the three.
Coming in slow. Puts it up. Oh.
Marchuk misses his shot.
Boutestein gets the rebound.
Dishes it off to Sarah. Oh, gets it intercepted. Marchuk has no clue.
Trying to bust through the D.
Oh, tosses it up.
Oh,
it's a fight. Oh. If it was a fight, I'd bet my money on Sarah.
All right. Sarah bounds the ball. Tries to make it over to Kenworth. Gets it.
Tries to put it over to Boutestein.
Well, here we go. Here comes the AV promo, I guess.
We'll be back.
I'm Marilyne Trombley here with entertainment again this week. We're gonna get off sports for a little while, but don't worry, I'll talk about them. For movies this weekend, there's Beautiful Girls with Rosie O'Donnell and Uma Thurman. Mr. Wrong starts today, starring Ellen from the sitcom Ellen, and Bill Pullman. Sense and Sensibility, this is a winner of 2 Golden Globes. That starts right away. Broken Arrow, that's with Travolta and Christian Slater. A lot of girls might like that one. The Juror, starring Demi Moore and Alec Baldwin. Big movie, too. And City Hall, starring Al Pacino and Bridget Fonda. Those are a lot of big names in those movies, so maybe you want to catch those this weekend. For sports, there's hockey. And one of my favorites, Oilers are playing tonight, actually, on CFRN Channel 3, Cable 2, at 6:30, if you want to catch that. And tomorrow night, this is really important, I'm telling you all, that 6 o'clock here at the Morinville Arena, the Morinville Midget AA Warriors are playing the Edson Sabres. You better be there. They need your support. That's at 6:30 tomorrow night, the 17th. And, other sports, there's basketball. You've been watching a lot here, and I promise you that the teams playing in the tournament are better than the MCTV crew. So that should be a lot of fun. I'm just enjoying a lot of action here in the gym. And I don't know, they play, the finals are tomorrow night at 7:15. The tournament's been on for a while, and there should be some good basketball teams from all around the province and maybe even further. If you want to go to the bar, the Rebar has a minstrel on speed tonight, and have fun on Family Day. A nice long weekend. See you guys next week.
Fascinating entertainment.
Whew, that basketball tired me out. I'm just sweating.
Yeah, I'd just like to say big thanks and congratulations to Mr. Cassavet for trying to screw up Merrill, and he tried hard but didn't succeed. What's that you got there?
My 1 McChicken sandwich. You get a medium or large fries, and you get a free McChicken. There you go. There's my random act of kindness for this week.
I'm touched.
It's all right, man. So we think we're gonna catch up. I think we're losing 2-1 or something like that.
Are we?
I think we're losing 2-1.
With that action basket I just scored there, I don't know.
You're pretty good. I'm playing defense because I'm a big boned person.
But he can get up there. He can grab the hoop. Okay, yes, anyway, we're going to a video by Todd Graham, and was it Michelle Diacabo on there?
Joy.
The mountains win again.
Love again will blow my mind and maybe it'll well be that love that got away from me. Is there all I'm too right that could make you cry?
Hey, we're back at the game. Boutestein decided to have free throws because he was getting beat like a rented mule. So we'll go back to the game here.
Breakhurst has a ball at the foul line. Shoots,
he misses
his
shot.
2-0 for the Savage Trout. Breakhurst shoots another one up.
This, whoever wins this competition will be a winner take all. Who do you think will win, Kevin?
Experience.
All right, it's 2-1 for the Savage Trout.
Sarah steps up. Oh, she's off, but she was more on than Breakroot.
Oh, yeah. Second shot. And that's a no-go off the front of the rim. Takes her shirt, third shot, and that's off also.
Woollven steps up. God, that guy's got skinny legs.
He didn't want to go for the free throw competition. I'm wondering if maybe his technique's off or something. He's getting ready.
He's getting hyped up.
Oh, and that's off. It was a close one, I'd say. Wouldn't you say? Shoots again.
Woollven. Oh, it's off again. The free throw percentages. Oh, takes his glasses off. That's like Jordan shooting blind. Oh, and here he's going to do it.
He's going to shoot blind.
Oh, that's
right off the top of the backboard.
No depth perception whatsoever. Boutestein steps up.
Steps up. He's ready. He's pumped. Looks like he's going to go for it, folks. Shoots.
That's off.
That's off.
Need a little more arc on it. Maybe some backspin. Center it a little.
Shoots again.
That's off again.
And that's a way off, folks. That was just sad. Third one.
That's off again. Can anybody hit a shot?
I don't know. Okay,
here comes Shayne
for the Rhinos. Okay, they're getting pumped up. They're getting them ready.
He's pumped. Oh,
getting him good
pumped.
To go.
But that's part of the reason why they're called the Rhinos.
Oh, yeah.
Feet are on the line, but I don't think that matters.
Shoots.
Oh, that's off.
That's off. Is it for the second shot? Woollven giving him a little inspiration there.
Another shot. That's off.
Just barely off.
He's got one more shot, folks. No pressure.
Okay, after this shot... Savage Trout
wins. Oh, the Savage Trout wins.
Promo. See ya.
Yeah.
Okay. Your point?
No. Oh, you got a match out right there.
Hi, we're here. We got Mr. Fine. Just to wrap up the sports like theme, we want to talk about Mr. Dress Up. Here you go, sir.
He's a very sports.
It's a very sad day in the entertainment world. Mr. Dress Up is retiring. No more tickle trunk. No more of his wonderful antics.
Yeah. I love you, Mr. Dress Up.
I know.
I love you.
We wish him well in Florida.
Very nice.
Thanks, guys.
Good luck in Florida. What's his
name?
He looks a little bit broken up.
I miss.
That was a humiliating loss.
It was a humiliating loss, but it's okay because we're coming back next year for the All Star game.
We will totally dominate.
All this was a little practice, a little warm up.
Yeah.
We're warmed up.
Next time, I kind of threw the last shot there on my.
You gotta give him a chance. Mr. B, you want marks, you know.
Exactly, it's all about grades.
He's not gonna see this, is he?
I meant
great victory by Mr. Boutestein.
Great victory. Congratulations.
Like most people do.
And next week's show is gonna be about, we'll see you then.
Bye.
Bye. She breathes.